Ryan Cruz fighting Vito Maneki on the undercard of Canelo Munguia. Break down Canelo Munguia.
It's going to be a great fight. I think Canelo's experience should take over.
Canelo has a better corner?
Yeah. I think Munguia is a great fighter. Spardo, I think Freddie's a great guy too, but I think Canelo's special. So I think that's going to make a difference.
And if I was a fighter, I'd rather have Eddie Reynoso in my corner.
Hey.
Listen, he took
I
Canelo.
I'd rather have Virgil Hill in my corner.
Virgil! He's part of the best Olympic team ever.
Yes, sir.
1988.
Yeah, 84.
He is.
Right, 84? He knows more shit than he knows.
84 or 88? Which Olympic team was he?
I don't know.
Virgil, 84 Olympics or 88?
84.
84, the best Olympic team ever. With Purnell. With who else?
Holyfield
got robbed.
Yeah.
Same
thing. The guy hit him and he hit him back after the bell. So he knocked him out. So.
But he went on to be undisputed in cruiserweight, yeah, heavyweight. He beat Mike Tyson.
Yeah.
He also fought James Toney and got knocked out in the ninth. It happened. Boxing.
Yeah.
Did you have a sparring vendor?
No. Never
you ever fight him?
No. Never did.
How would you do if you fought him?
I would have tried to outbox him, but Evander was one of those guys, really great
smart
guy.
Yep. Very humble, very religious, very soft-spoken.
Yeah, but he knew boxing. He watched film, even during the Olympics. He was watching film with the guys.
What were you doing during the Olympics?
Losing weight.
Well, when you're not a heavyweight,
I was cutting weight hard.
Today in the Olympics?
During the Olympics.
Right now, in the Olympics, in this day and age,
yeah,
it's one big party. Everybody hooks up with everyone. Was that how it was in 84?
No.
You didn't party the whole time?
The best spot. It didn't matter if you were the first guy or the tenth guy. Whoever was the best guy in the training camp, win.
You won the silver, right?
Yeah.
Did you get a call from the president? Did Ronald Reagan call you and say, hey?
No. But he shook my hand when I went up there.
And what did he tell you?
Nothing.
What did you tell him?
Nice to meet you. Hi.
Who's your favorite fighter in the world today?
My favorite fighter, Canelo Whitaker was phenomenal.
No, today, active.
Yeah, today. It would be the boy from Nebraska.
Gervonta Davis? Baltimore?
No.
You're talking
Baltimore.
About Terrence Crawford?
Yeah.
How would he do in your era?
Very well. He's a throwback.
He would do good with the Hagler, Hearns, Duran, Leonard.
I think he's a good throwback. Yeah.
Anybody else from our era that you think would do good in that era?
I don't know. It's a different time, you know.
So you only say only Crawford? What about Canelo? How would he do in your era?
I don't know. He would have been facing guys like Hearns, Leonard.
He would have loved it.
Well, he would have loved it, but that doesn't mean he would have won.
How does Canelo do with Hagler and Hearns? And Leonard?
I don't know, man.
What? No way. No way, Virgil.
Boxing's changed, bro. Different times. I don't know.
Scrappy. Canelo versus Hagler,
look,
Hearns.
Look, these guys are not finishers. Those guys were finishers.
So Gervonta Davis, 29-0, 27 knockouts. It's a big finisher.
I'm just saying.
There's another Virgil Ortiz, 20-0, 20 knockouts.
Yeah. I'm just saying, look back. So you gotta look at the quality of fighters that they were fighting.
But everybody says that always. A basketball player, we'll say the basketball players in the 80s were tough for a
minute. Yeah, you're breaking records that were, you know, at a different time, you know, so it's not the same, advantages and stuff. They have more advantages than back in the day. Same as our era, you know, it was the same thing, you know.
When you were in the Olympic team, do you realize it was one of the best Olympic teams ever? Did you know that?
It was another tournament. I was cutting weight. I didn't spend time with anybody. I was busy doing my own thing.
Are you friends with any of them to this day?
I mean, we're friends with all of them, but we don't. It's not like we break bread together.
You call them
like
sometimes?
No.
So you're not friends?
We're friends, but
You're homies. Like, what's up? But you're not friends.
But I don't have homies and stuff like that.
Why not?
I don't have time.
Scrappy, how many friends do you have?
Close friends?
There you go. He's right there. That tells you.
He has no
friends. Right there. That tells you.
I mean, I have friends, but I don't. It's hard because I don't invest time into my relationship. It's hard.
That's everybody. That's all. Anybody that's in it to win it
has no life.
You have a life, but it's a different life. It's a different life.
What about who makes more money, today or back then?
Today.
Virgil, what shoes did you wear when you boxed? You had like 80 pro fights.
Adidas High Top.
Were they comfortable?
Yeah. I mean, to me.
Did you guys run a lot? What did you do conditioning?
I ran a lot. That's why I got knee surgery.
Both knees are messed up, huh? Yeah, is that from boxing?
Well, just through the course of time.
Wearing tear.
Running on hard pavement. The shoes today that these guys have and stuff are way different than back in the day, you know?
Different style of training too, personal trainers. Yeah. You didn't have personal training back then. You just did sit-up, push-ups, and running, right?
Yeah.
Any weights?
Yeah.
Any supplements?
No.
Anybody take steroids in your era?
Yeah.
Who?
Oh, just about all the heavyweights.
How do you know they took steroids?
Well, if you can gain 30 pounds of lean muscle mass in a few months, you take a steroid.
But did you see on them? Like, just
I didn't have to see. You just got to know about what it is.
Is everybody cheating? Like Nate Diaz says, everyone's on steroids today. We don't know. Scrappy, are fighters on steroids in this day and age? Yeah.
That's the opponent was.
How do you know?
Says they're positive.
Oh, that's messed up.
I got the call after I was dead.
The guy you knocked out? Wow. Sorry to hear that. Did he hit hard?
I hit hard.
His last opponent tested dirty.
Huh?
His last opponent tested dirty. That's messed up.
Well, I mean, it was a huge opportunity.
Okay, so Scrappy, what should be the punishment of someone who took steroids?
What do you think?
What should be the punishment for a person who takes steroids? Banning or suspending?
Suspend.
Give me a little suspension.
Everybody, how long? A week?
Mistakes.
A month?
Well, not long ago if you smoked pot. But now it's legal.
Does it make you a better fighter smoking?
It's anything, yeah, but you're breathing it into your lungs.
There's different ways.
It's going into your lungs and it's killing all those little fibers and shit there. Yeah.
So you don't recommend it?
There's different ways of intaking it nowadays.
Yeah. Smoke is smoke.
No, shit.
What about alcohol? Can I be a fighter and drink?
No, you shouldn't. Alcohol is worse because it's man-made.
So worse than weed?
I wouldn't recommend either. You know, just because of your lungs. You inhale that into your lungs, the smoke comes out. There's a lot of guys that smoke. Everybody in here.
Yeah.
Smoke.
That's true. Last thing, Virgil. Can fighters hook up with their girls before fight?
Depends on the person. What you believe.
That's true.
Right?
Yep.
You think it will happen? You think it gives you weak legs, it gives you weak legs.